E aí, pessoal do Filter Brasil, tudo bem? Aqui quem fala é a Lorena Tucci. Bom, para quem não me conhece, eu sou atriz da série Influencer e hoje eu invadi aqui o canal para apresentar um quadro que eu amo muito, que é o Behind the Music, com nada mais, nada menos do que Zara Larsson. E hoje ela vai contar um pouquinho pra gente sobre a música Love Me Light. So please join me in welcoming the gorgeous Sweden singer and songwriter Zara Larsson.
Hey! Hi! Thank you. What a nice introduction.
Thank you so much for having us, Zara. So today we're going to talk about your music that reached top 50 in 9 countries and the top in Sweden. And I'm talking about Love Me Light. How do you feel about
Hey. I feel so happy about it. I feel so proud. And I don't know. It just feels good in my heart that it's out. I just think it's a banger. And I think it really represents me sonically, like as an artist. I think it's really good. So I were in the studio for like a week with Justin Tranter and Julia Michaels, who are two of the most amazing songwriters in pop. So if you have a song, a pop song that you're like, I really like this song, it's probably them who wrote it, honestly. So we were in the studio and I was just chatting and chatting and chatting about like, I'm so in love with this guy. I love him so much. And they were like, let's just write a song about it, like you do, you know? So we were in the studio with the producer, who's also a Swedish guy. He's called Jason Gill. And we also worked together before. We did Funeral from So Good. And we just started talking about like ABBA. And we started talking about how cool they are and how like their music, if it was released today, honestly, it would be just as big. I really believe so. They're just like so special. The melodies, the instruments, particularly one song that it's my personal favorite, which is Lay All Your Love on Me. It's so sh the chorus is so short. It's just like, don't go wasting your emotions. Lay all your love on me. That's it, like times two. That's the chorus. And I thought that was so fresh to do that, even though it's an older song. Because most pop songs have this, like, and then we need a big chorus, you know? And I wanted to do the opposite. I wanted the verses to be like, take me there. And then the chorus to be kind of like pulled back, but still effectful with a lot of harmonies. So I was really inspired by ABBA on that one. And then we just wrote about the feeling of being in love. Like you're in Love Me Land. You're in your own little world and you have a great time. You don't even need to think about anything else. Like no need to sleep, no need to eat. You know when you're like really, really in love with someone and just getting text messages is like, And that's just the place where you want to be at all times. At least I do. I think love is like the reason why we are alive, like to feel that feeling. But it could
I
also be scary. It could be scary, you know? Especially if you have like your heart broken or you've been a little sad and you might think like it's not worth it. But when you get into that feeling again, you remember like, oh, this is what it feels like and it's definitely worth it. Even though I might get my heart broken, I really hope I won't. But you know, it's worth it. It's worth feeling that feeling of happiness. And that's what the song is about, being brave enough and being like to dare to be loved and to dare to love someone. Well, that's a good question because it doesn't necessarily have to be like about me. I saw one comment somewhere, it was like, oh, maybe it's about loving yourself. You know, you just look in your mirror and you're like talking to yourself, like, how dare you be this fine and like have a lips like that? Ooh, you kiss so good. Like you're in Love Me Land. So it could be that. But to me, again, it was about me meeting someone that I just really connected with, that I fell so in love with. And it just happened. I didn't plan it to. We were friends for a while, and then we just like, nah, like I love you.
I like you, yeah.
And that is a scary step, you know, because you don't want a friendship, but it could also take you to like, woo! Yeah. Well, I always wanted a video of just myself dancing. So the video is, it's just me in a really big space. I wanted to just dance, to have a video where I dance so people can see me do that, because not a lot of people know that I can. And I don't know if the location would have been different if it was like Corona was not around, but I would have been dancing by myself, I think, still. And then it fitted so well with the world that we're in right now, because it's very social distancing, you know, yes. It's very Corona friendly. It was shot directed over a live link. So like the director was in another country watching it on a screen. And I was a little nervous. I was like, is this gonna work? But it worked out really fine. It
so
really...
you did all by yourself. Like you were in one place and the director was in another one.
In another place. And then of course we had like a small crew on like doing the camera, doing all that. But I've never done that before. And I don't think I would have even thought about it if it wasn't for the coronavirus being around. But also that's something that I might take with me now, because it worked out really fine. It was perfect. Because I was so sad. I was like, oh, am I not going to be able to work with Vivi Huska, who is the director, because of this? And then, ta-da, you know, technology. The fact that we can talk right now, I think it's so great. And I don't know if we didn't have this, we probably, if anything, would have spoken on the phone. Or maybe just like send some short clip, like, you know, it's not the same. So it did give us a little something that we could take with us in the future, maybe. But I don't know
how to use it.
Yeah, which is so great because it works. Of course, I would have loved to see you like in real life, but this is like as close as we can get, I guess. I use Instagram. I thought the reactions were really good. Everybody that's seen it loves it, which makes me really happy. But I'm also always so like hard on myself. I'm like, why didn't my video get 100 million views in a day? Like, I don't think, and that's why I also have to remind myself, like, the numbers never gonna make me happy. It's the reactions of people that I will really take with me. Because you also get so used to the numbers. Yeah. Like, now, I wouldn't say, like, to be honest, it hasn't done commercially as well as my other songs yet, but I am, in a way, more proud of this one. And I feel really good about it. Even if it literally only had one view, I would be like, yeah, that's me. I watched it because I love it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just feel really happy and proud over my next project and what's to come. And that is really true success. And then, of course, I want my fans to like it as well. If I didn't want that, it wouldn't be a point of me even releasing music. But I don't know. I'm genuinely, I feel really good. I gotta learn. I don't know it yet. I mean, what if they like take TikTok from us? We'll see how they're gonna do in America at least. Mm-hmm. But I will definitely learn it. I've said I'm gonna get on. I am on TikTok, but I only have a private account. I haven't posted anything. I only like.
Wait, why? We would love to see it. Come on.
I know I should. I should really get on it. It would be so fun.
And you know that you have many fans here in Brazil, so including me. Can you please leave a message for them?
Of course. Oi, Brazil. I can't wait to see you soon. I miss you a lot. I had the best time last time I was there. And I hope to see all of you guys very soon. Just stay healthy and stay safe. And I see you on the other side.
Oh, you were amazing. Thank you so much for your time, Zara. And just one last question.
Yeah, of course.
Can we expect a new single this year?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, no, it's going to come soon. Yeah, we're ready. We're ready to go. This is what's different about this year, too. It's like last few times, I feel like I've dropped a single, and then I'm like, here's a song, bye. But you know, now I'm like, I have this coming up, and then I have this coming up, then I have the album, then we're doing this. Like, we have a plan in a different way now. So I'm going to keep you guys fed.
Amazing. I love that. Thank you so much.
Thanks. It was so nice talking to you.
It was really nice. Thank you. Really. Bye. Bom, pessoal, essa foi a entrevista com a Zara. Então, espero que vocês tenham gostado. Se inscrevam no canal e ativem o sininho para não perderem nenhuma notificação.